Hello and welcome back to another Closer Look, this time diving deep into Requiem for a Dream. Our first character we'll introduce is Sarah. She has quite the obsession over TV infomercials and receives a phone call that she won to participate on a TV game show. Reflecting on her current weight, she seeks out amphetamine diet pills to shave off fat to fit in her ruby-colored dress. The doctor recommended four colored pills that she should take daily: a purple pill in the morning, a blue one in the afternoon, orange in the evening, and green at night. Throughout the movie, you see Sarah's sanity fade as she starts to mix the pills to indulge the euphoria and escape the hunger. She experiences hallucinations of the refrigerator jolting left and right in a rigorous manner, and then proceeding to calm as she takes more pills. Towards the end of the movie, her sanity is lost and she began to experience amphetamine psychosis, which includes symptoms such as paranoia, anxiety, hallucinations, aggressiveness, and difficulty concentrating. She is later, unknowingly to her, to be instituted within a psych ward and later experience shock therapy. Her past life is gone as she does not recognize her old friends from her same apartment complex. This is the sad life that Sarah now must live. Next, we dive in a closer look to the son of Sarah, Harry. Harry is introduced into the film with stealing his mother's television set and pawning it off for money. Harry is alongside with his friend Tyrone as they use the money to buy drugs and listen to music. Harry and Tyrone only sees potential in using and selling drugs. With the power of heroin, their only focus is consuming and selling the drugs, to only wanting to consume more. Tyrone and Harry's operation was successful for a while, until Tyrone was imprisoned for fleeing a gang assassination. Tyrone's bail set back the income of their future and is stagnant with the climb of succession with selling drugs. As a mass drug operation turns sour, their conclusion is to go directly to the source in Florida. At this point in the film, the state of mind of the characters are drug-induced entirely. There seems to be no humanity left within them. Harry's arm is suffering due to excess needle injections. He is demanded to be taken to a hospital. Tyrone and Harry split due to legal actions. Tyrone is sent to prison while Harry recovers in a hospital. Harry experiences withdrawals and his confusion only makes him worse. His arm is amputated and he is left crying on the hospital bed. Next up, we're going to dive deep into the psyche of Harry's girlfriend, Marion. Marion shows potential of being a fashion designer or an artist, but with the company of Harry, this halts her career. Marion's story progresses with her involvement in obtaining drugs with Harry and Tyrone. After Tyrone's first imprisonment, Harry insists Marion to sell her body to the psychiatrist. After obtaining money, Harry and Tyrone engage on the bigger drug operation to score more heroin. With the downfall of obtaining more heroin, she decided to use her sex again to acquire more drugs. Tyrone lends Marion the number of a pimp who sells drugs in exchange for sex. Marion chases this life and continues to keep exchanging her body for drugs. At the end of the film, she is seen on her couch smiling, clutching a bag of heroin. Finally, we dive into Tyrone, the friend of Harry. He is the progressive character in this movie. Tyrone helps Harry progress in their income, and even sometimes suggests to hold off on the drugs in order to sell more. This mentality soon fades as their steep in addiction creases. He is imprisoned twice due to the involvement with drugs, and is broken down towards the end of the movie. With the separation of Harry, he is stuck in prison and is last seen crying in his bed. Heroin binds to and activates certain receptors in the brain called mu opioid receptors, or MORs. Once heroin enters the brain, it is converted to morphine and binds rapidly to opioid receptors. Abusers typically report feeling a surge of pleasurable sensation, a rush of some sort. The intensity of the rush is a function of how much drug is intaken and how rapidly the drug enters the brain and binds to the opioid receptors. The rush is usually accompanied by a warm flushing of the skin, dry mouth, and a heavy feeling in the extremities, which may be accompanied by nausea, vomiting, and severe itching. After the initial effects, users will become drowsy for several hours. Mental function is clouded, heart function slows, and breathing is also severely slowed, sometimes enough to be life-threatening. Slow breathing can also lead to coma and permanent brain damage.